morning, everybody, and welcome to the vlog. Here's the deal, guys. I lied to you guys, but not in a bad way, but I did lie. So more on that later. For now, I want to share something with you. And what I wanted to share was, remember that potential banana camo clutch that I was like, I think I might have hit a banana camo, but it wasn't what I was expecting? Well, I want to share those results really quick. Again, these are just normal spinners here. They're not chocolate spinners or anything, so nothing too special there. They're just spider and pinstripes. And then we have here, we have a little banana spinner, which again is a banana, it's a spider, and it's a pinstripe. And then we actually have these three right here. These are actually banana chocolate spinners, right? Now this particular one here had some kind of unusual pattern to it, and this was the last egg that I cut in that clutch. And it turns out that it wasn't a banana camo. It just had some interesting pattern to it, and I thought maybe that was a banana camo, and I was disappointed. So it turns out that we whiffed on this clutch. There are no banana camos in this clutch, just some banana chocolate spinners. And it's really interesting, if you see the three of these, how different they look. One is almost completely patternless. One you can see just a little bit of pattern on, and then this one has quite a bit of pattern. And the one with the quite a bit of pattern was the last egg, and I thought it looked like it maybe was a banana camo. So guess what, guys? Looks like we didn't hit the purple snake in this clutch. So back to that lie. It really wasn't a lie. It was more like a mistake. And that mistake that I made was actually, believe it or not, we had one more clutch that I didn't realize. We only had like 12 clutches of ball pythons left in the incubator, and when I was going through them, I thought we only had one clutch, but it turns out this clutch here is actually a chocolate pinstripe bed to a banana chocolate spinner. So guess what, guys? We have one more shot at it. So I didn't really lie to you. I just made a mistake and didn't realize that we actually had another shot. So when I said we didn't hit the banana camo this year, guess what? We still have one more shot, and these guys are actually pipped out now, so they are really ready to go. So let's just go ahead, jump and cut this clutch, and let's hope this is really the last chance that we have for a banana camo. I promise you guys, I won't come back with another video saying that I didn't have it. We only have like 10 or 11 clutches to go, and there is definitely no other shot at it. So the first animal in this clutch is actually surprisingly just a spider ball python. So it's just a single gene. That one wasn't very good. We're gonna go ahead, cut this egg here. This one I can already see because it's already pipped. It is definitely not anything other than a... Oh, this is actually a camo ball python here. So this is exactly what I'm looking for, but in a banana. So this is what it looks like. And you can see that dark chocolate right there definitely is gonna turn into a purplish snake, if what I think is correct, regardless. So we hit a camo. So we know there's a chance to produce the banana camo. Weird, this is a normal ball python, people. So we hit a spider and a normal and then a camo. That is weird. There's an egg way down on the bottom here. I'm gonna do my best. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna remove this egg right here. It actually almost popped right off, so I can get to this bottom egg and actually see what is going on in here. Oh my gosh, we're really whiffing on a lot of things here, guys. This is just a normal spinner ball python, a spider and a pinstripe. So we're not really getting great odds on this clutch. We still have four eggs to go, so let's just go ahead and hope for the best. Come on, banana camo. Come on, what do we have here? What do we have here? Ah! No, 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 it looks like, well, it's really pretty. It's a banana chocolate pinstripe. The banana chocolate pins are ridiculous. Not the camo though. So, okay, we've got three eggs left for the year, people. Three eggs left for the entire year. Let's see what we have. A chocolate pinstripe, so no banana. Okay, so we've got two eggs left. Two eggs left to potentially produce the animal I've been dreaming about. Come on, I thought I had like a reprieve with one more clutch. I'm like, yes, I can finally produce it. Oh my gosh, let's see what we have here. Ooh, this one popped right out. What do we got? Oh, another banana chocolate pinstripe. Guys, we're down to one egg. One egg that could potentially produce the banana camo. 2 years in the running, people. 2 years I've been waiting for this animal. I thought we were done when that last clutch hatched. I was like, oh, no banana camos this year. Get this clutch. We are down to one egg. Deep breaths, deep breaths, deep breaths. Come on, I could tell it's a banana. I could tell it's a banana right off the chance. Ah! Guess what, people? Another banana chocolate pinstripe. So another year comes, another year goes, and we didn't hit the banana camo. Remember, we did hit three of the banana pastel camos, but we didn't see that purple banana camo. Oh my God, this is my nemesis. I guess we have to wait another year, people, unless someone else beats me to it. I don't know, maybe someone else will. So I promise you guys, no more lies, no more clutches. This was our last chance, and guess what? We missed it. So all in all, you know, odds are odds, right? So a lot of people that get into the reptile kind of breeding type of thing think like, oh, there's 1 in 4 odds to produce that particular recessive mutation or whatever. Sometimes it works, sometimes you beat the odds, sometimes the odds crush you. You know, this is obviously an ivory Burmese python named Marshmallow, by the way. She is absolutely adorable. But the fact is that a Burmese project that I worked with in the past, albino labyrinth Burmese, were probably my worst odds I've ever had. Now let me just back up a second. Burmese pythons way back in the day in the 90s were the big thing. Just like ball pythons are now. Believe it or not, people bred giant snakes. That was like the big thing, and that was the thing that everyone was working with. So I bought a pair of double head albino labyrinth Burmese pythons for $25,000. Now I raised them up in a couple years and bred them. On average, the odds would be 1 in 16 that I would produce an albino labyrinth Burmese. On the 127th egg is the first albino labyrinth Burmese python that I produced. It took me 4 years of production to finally get the albino labyrinth. And I think at that time, to be honest with you, they were like a few hundred bucks. I definitely lost my shirt on that one, but the fact is that the banana camo is about 1 in 8 odds, and I've now produced about 10 clutches over the last 2 years and have yet to hit one. Of course, we hit the pastels, but I'm looking for the one that I really want, that purple snake. So I've had probably 70 or 80 eggs with the odds being about 1 in 8. Definitely have missed the odds on this one, and I guess I'm gonna have to wait till next year. But speaking about beautiful Burmese pythons like this, I actually have a guy later in the vlog that's coming for us to sex some little baby Burmese. So guys, you know that I absolutely love t-shirts. I'm kind of a t-shirt freak, you know what I mean? So I got a bunch of really cool new t-shirts in that I wanna show you guys. That's right, today I'm introverting. So I figure, while I'm showing you these t-shirts, let's see how many crazy transitions we can get into. That's right, and today is gonna be a really good day. Sorry I'm late, I really didn't wanna come. And that is a lot of what my life is about. How about this one? Yeah, some days are like that. You just wanna kinda sleep on it, you know what I mean? So I tell you, and yeah, some days you just need someone to love you. And yeah, every day does seem like leg day. As a matter of fact, I just had leg day today, as a matter of fact. So there's my shirt collection. If you guys enjoyed it, let me know which one was your favorite. And by the way, down in the comments, if you know some really cool shirts, let me know. I'd like to get some more because they're absolutely amazing. I know it's absolutely crazy that we're still cutting eggs, we're hatching babies, and we are literally on the cusp of starting breeding pythons again. Just in about a month, we're gonna start pairing some stuff up. And you know, the Bongo gene is something I don't talk a lot about. It's a codominant gene in ball pythons that's really cool. This is actually a pastel Enchi Bongo that is almost up to size that hopefully will breed later this year. And this little monkey is a male that should definitely be ready to go. This is a pastel Lesser Cinnaby Bongo. That is a lot of genes, but I tell you what, that's gonna make for some cool babies. The Bongo gene is something that a lot of people aren't working with necessarily. It's been around for probably, I don't know, maybe 5 or 6 years, something on that lines. But nevertheless, I'm excited for next year because we have a bunch of really cool Bongo stuff coming up. And this one here is definitely one of my favorites. This is actually a Pastavi Bongo. That actually is het for ghost. What a crazy animal. So again, it's pastel, it's Mojave, and that Bongo changes the color and pattern so much. I mean, absolutely incredible. So although we're just finishing up 2019 when it comes to the breeding season and hatching, we are gearing up for 2020 already. And speaking of shirts, my buddy Dave Hardy actually sent me this from Hardy's Pythons. I actually love this shirt a lot. And if you guys wanna send me a shirt, I am always happy to do it. I wear a large, by the way. P.O. Box is always in the description. So I had a local guy actually reach out to me and he hatched out some Burmese pythons. Didn't know what the sex of them was. So he called up and said, hey Brian, can you sex these out? And I'm always happy to help out, you know that thing. Well, baby Burmese can be a little cantankerous. I used to produce a ton of them. And trust me, when we had 30 or 40 babies, it was like I was a pincushion. They would just bite and bite and bite. I don't know if these babies are gonna be the same, but let's go ahead and hook up with this guy and sex some baby Burmese. Wish me luck. All right, so my buddy is in the house and he brought, what, 8 berms? You got eight little, berms? 8 little, yes, babies eight to berms. Hatch. And these things are gorgeous. I mean, unbelievable. Just take a look at some of these ones here. Oh, doggy, that is beautiful. That is a hypo there. There's all kinds of stuff. There's pearls, there's hypo granites, all kinds of stuff. So I'm excited to look at these. Not so sure if I'm excited about sexing them because they are these guys nippy or are they all right?
Yeah, they're nippy.
Nippy, I figured that. All right, well, let's just go ahead and gear up because we're about to get bit. All right, so let's just jump into this. Again, berms can be a little bit crazy as babies. Again, this is a beauty right here. And what basically we're trying to do is we're just gonna avert the hemipenes here, right? So basically what happens is you got the base of the tail here and this is the anal vent right here. And we're just gonna roll with our thumb and actually avert them and see what's males and females. And hopefully we won't get bit too much. Right off the bat, you can see right there that basically there's nothing in there. And what I'm trying to do is roll the hemipenes pains out because they're down in the base of the tail here. If you squish them down, they're not gonna actually pop out, right? So the idea is to roll way back here, roll towards the vent, and then give a little counter pressure. This is a little girl, and again, it's a hypo, and it's gorgeous. And guess what, guys? We did our first snake, and we didn't get bit yet. And here's another little hypo here. And so far, these guys have been pretty good. Like I said, you know, a lot of times these things will just be absolute maniacs, like biting you like crazy. But again, that hypo gene is unbelievable. It just brightens them up. It reduces the melanin and makes them absolutely gorgeous, that's for sure. And of course, the super hypos are the ivories, just like our marshmallow, right? The really cool things that, oh, he's looking at me. He's like, don't do it. He's right. I mean, that's where this goes. So I have a feeling just by looking at this is gonna be a boy.
Okay.
So I'm gonna show you what I mean. So I'm gonna go ahead, I'm gonna take this like this, and I'm just gonna roll up like this. I'm gonna apply some back pressure. Oh, turns out that it's actually a girl. It looked like a boy just from the kind of baseline of his tail, but okay. This is definitely a girl too. So a really beautiful animal, and still no bites yet. So things are going very well. Oh, look what we have here. This is a cute little monkey right here. This, of course, is just like Jeffrey here. This is a hypo granite, probably one of my favorite Burmese mutations. I'm not gonna lie to you. I just think they're absolutely incredible. This guy is so absolutely cute. So again, same thing right here, base of the tail. Gonna just roll up, see what we have here. So far, we've been getting all females, which is really crazy. The little mini Jeffrey here is another girl. Our first normal Burmese python right here. This one looks like a feisty little monkey for sure. Whoa, hello now, come on, buddy. And when you're sexing these guys, they usually get pretty upset with you, I'm not gonna lie. But we're gonna see what we have here. Come on, little monkey, you're all right. And again, normal Burmese, this was the first snake I ever got, was an animal that looked just like this, a normal Burmese python. I was 15 years old, my first pet snake. I've often said, not a great idea to get a Burmese python as the first snake, but that's just the way it goes. And although it's hissing and hissing and hissing, not too much. See, oh, oh God. got me. All right, casualty, down. You can see the two little hemipenes right there. That is a boy right there. So this is a little boy, and he's hissing like crazy. But so far, he's actually been pretty good, so that's really good. Usually when you sex these guys, they go at you for sure. So little cute little male normal Burmese python. Oh, this is absolutely gorgeous right here. This is actually what they would call a pearl granite, which is an albino hypogranite Burmese python. Wow. And I'm gonna be honest with you, I am blown away that I haven't been bit yet, because I don't think I've ever sexed this many Burmese pythons without looking like a pincushion. So let's go see what this girl or boy is right here. Looks like we've got another girl. So far we've got a lot of girls, just one little boy, but just take a look at that animal right there. That's amazing, and that's a triple mutation right there. So I tell you what, berms have come a long way in the last 20 years. There's a lot of incredible mutations, and this one is beautiful. It looks like this is just a normal albino Burmese python. It's got really an interesting pattern, but sometimes when you get into like the het granites and stuff like that, you'll have a little expression with the heteros. And the truth is that albino Burmese pythons are really what started my entire business. I told you that I had my first pet was a Burmese python, but when I bred albino Burmese pythons way back in the day, they were still like 1,250 bucks as babies, and I produced like 35 of them when I was like 17, maybe just turning 18 years old. That's a lot of money to kind of start my business, and that's what started BHB, was albino Burmese pythons. So that's pretty awesome, and I still love them to this day. You know I love Sunrise and all that stuff. So let's go ahead and see what we got here. It looks like we got another little male right on the button, right there. All right, we got, ooh, and this guy's, whew, what's the matter, little buddy? What's the matter? Yeah, he's looking at me, eyeing me up, but that's cool. So, awesome, where you go? That's a beautiful snake. We have another little hypo Burmese right here. Man, I tell you what, those hypos are incredible. Again, when I used to breed Burmese pythons, there weren't nearly the amount of mutations, so it's cool to kind of see them. It's been a while since I've played with a bunch of baby Burmese pythons. They are cool. I don't know, man, they're just awesome. So let's go ahead and see what this little monkey is. Come on, little buddy. I cannot believe I've not been bit yet. This is another little girl. So far we've had only a couple males and a bunch of girls, but whew, I tell you what, that is an incredible snake. Whew. Man, I tell you what, that is a snake right there.
Oh, snake.
This is, of course, a pearl Burmese python. So the hypo albino. Oh my gosh, that thing is a ripper. Man, I tell you what, I love that. It's crazy. When this thing gets bigger, it's gonna be so beautiful. So I tell you what, I think just by looking, it's another girl. Oh, you little sucker. Finally, my first bite. All right, little monkey, come on. Calm down, little dude. So I have a feeling this is another girl, and yes, I would be correct to assume that. Oh, look at this little dude.
Oh.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Calm down, calm down. Ow! I knew I wasn't gonna get away without some bites. It just turned out that it was the last one. So this is the last one. It is a little girl, and hey, a couple little bites for sexing a bunch of berms, that's a lot better than I thought it was gonna be. So obviously I didn't mean to lie to you guys, and what a crazy result of that clutch, right? If you guys enjoyed egg cutting today, here's another egg cutting video, an entire playlist of egg cutting. Over here you can hit that subscribe button, and while you're at it, turn those post notifications on. Have a wonderful day, be kind to someone, and I promise I'll see you guys tomorrow.